पॉइंट नंबर 14, टू एंजॉय योर लाइफ टू द फुलेस्ट लर्न टू कॉन्शियसली ब्रिंग अबाउट द चेंजेस इन योर लाइफ द वे यू वॉन्ट थ्रू कंटेम्पलेशन एंड मेडिटेशन. हैव द स्पिरिट ऑफ इंक्वायरी. लिसन टू ऑल कंसर्न बट टेक डिसीजंस ऑफ योर लाइफ ओनली एज पर योर इनर वॉइस. डू नॉट बी अ पार्ट ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल स्लेवरी. वॉक द पाथ ऑफ साइंटिफिक स्पिरिचुअलिटी एंड बी अ लाइट अन टू योर सेल्फ. अ वेरी वेरी लॉन्ग पैराग्राफ विथ सो मेनी ब्यूटिफुल थिंग्स बिल्ट इन. ओके, लेट्स गो वन बाय वन. टू एंजॉय योर लाइफ टू द फुलेस्ट लर्न टू कॉन्शियसली ब्रिंग अबाउट द चेंजेस इन योर लाइफ. अनकॉन्सियस पीपल लाइफ इज ड्रिफ्टिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द डेस्टिनी. द मोमेंट यू बिकम कॉन्शियस, द मोमेंट यू बिकम अवेयर, you can create your destiny the way you want through conscious choices, but it demands a very high degree of awareness. When you become fully aware, you have the capacity to become co-creator along with the destiny. You can guide your destiny with your conscious choices. It is possible. But it is possible only for a highly aware person, not for everybody. A person who is absolutely unconscious is 100% guided by destiny. A person who is absolutely aware, men like Krishna, men like Buddha, they create their own destiny. And with a lesser degree of awareness, you are somewhere in between. Some portion of your life is governed by your destiny. Some portion you create your own destiny. Through contemplation and meditation you can choose. So when you contemplate on this aspect and you meditate more and more after doing the kriya, you will go deeper into meditation. With this you will be able to go higher in your awareness and you will make more and more conscious choices. You will gain power to create your own destiny. That is the way. Have the spirit of inquiry. We don't need blind faith in dogmas, in rituals. No. We have to have scientific temperament. We have to have spirit of inquiry. A blind faith is no good. Andhasraddha. We don't want Andhasraddha. The blind faith. It is better to have sense of inquiry. Explore. Do scientific experiments. Understand. Only then your conviction will grow. Blind faith person cannot have conviction. So sense of inquiry is a very good. Don't impose your ideas onto children. Rather, give them a sense of inquiry. Let them explore in their own way. They will become better human beings. See, for decision making, listen to all concerned, but take decisions of your life only as per your inner voice. Yes, people will have different opinions, but your inner voice also is a very important aspect. If you are conscious, if you are aware, if you are alert, you will have the capacity to listen to your inner voice, not otherwise. Your inner voice, your intuition is the greatest guide. It's the awakening of your inner guru. That is the best guidance that is available and that is available from inside. So learn to listen to your intuition. Learn to listen to that small voice, inner voice. That is the greatest guidance, intuition, available to you. Respect that and your decision will be always right. Do not be a part of spiritual slavery. Beautiful word. Many organizations I am associated with. The moment you become part of the organization, there are dogmas, there are rituals, there is cult formation, there is a father figure, the dictations, and you are governed by the rules and regulations. That is called spiritual slavery. when you are part of the spiritual slavery, enlightenment is not possible. So never ever be a part of spiritual slavery mentality, dictated by somebody who does not even know what is your position. I know many Swamis, they don't even meet people personally. Yesterday I heard from somebody that if you want to meet that Swami, minimum fees is $5,000 you deposit, only then you can have a personal meeting. And this cult formation is there. And there is a systematic brand promotions. And there is a very systematic strategy of creating the spiritual slavery. And people fall prey to these things. That is called spiritual slavery. Enlightenment is not possible that way. Enlightenment is a process of deep se deep jage. When you are personally in the aura of the spiritual master, you have your own problems. You can discuss your things. See how King Janak got enlightened? Sage Astavakra, he was talking one to one. And the understanding opened up and Janak got enlightened. That is what is Astavakra Gita. Now these modern gurus are becoming so big, they don't even meet their disciples. How enlightenment will happen? It is only the cult formation. And a common man gets trapped into that glamorous world, the brand promotion effect. And they lose track of their own enlightenment path. And they fall into what is known as spiritual slavery. And people get carried away by this glorified, glamorous world of spirituality, modern spirituality. And they have huge amounts of funds. And they use those funds for advertising and brand promotion. And people get caught up into this spiritual slavery. Enlightenment is not possible. A spiritual master, if he is a genuine, is a humble, simple person, available. See, Shirdi Sai Baba was a common man, available. You can go and walk and talk to him. I know these many modern Swamis are so arrogant, they will not even permit you to meet, neither alone nor in a group.